Dan Todd has been flying for about 7 months now. He'd never flown any kind of aircraft before May of 2020. Flying had been a childhood dream for Todd, and he always meant to learn. But between earning a medical degree, establishing himself as an ear, nose, and throat surgeon, and having a family, he just never found the time. Until the novel coronavirus came along.
When the virus came and the pandemic, our elective surgeries stopped. And so we were doing emergencies and cancer, and that's about it. So we were on call and doing cancer, but I basically had like 5 days a week off of nothing to do, and it couldn't work anywhere.
Todd started taking flying lessons in a fixed-wing aircraft at the T airport, but then, just in the course of conversation, his brother-in-law told him about gyroplanes, also known as gyrocopters or autogyros. A couple of brochures and a look at the history of gyroplanes piqued his interest.
And then I started researching it, and I found these guys in Missouri where I did my surgery training that were giving lessons and things and then had gyroplanes, and I started watching them. I go, oh my gosh, that's exactly what I want. You fly around like a bird and they don't stall. And so I made contact with them, and I was able to go down there on weekends for 4 or 5 times and just do lessons and lessons and lessons and learn how to fly this.
Todd bought his own gyroplane in Missouri and flew it home to Sioux Falls. He now flies out of the T airport whenever he gets the chance. Given the warm early winter of 2020, it's been almost every day.
And as long as you wear gloves and a coat, they're not too bad.
Todd likes the fact that the way the gyroplane works makes it a comparatively safe aircraft.
Well, the rotor is a free spinning rotor. There's no power to it. Now, there's a little bit of a hydraulic power to get it started, just to get it started, pre-rotate it. The old guys, they used to have these things, or they'd have a motor, and they'd have to get up there and start spinning them on their own, the Benson gyroplanes, and they'd have to spin their own rotor to get it spinning, and then they'd go over it. This self-spins, and then the rotor kind of ends up, like as you're flying, it ends up kind of catching the wind and spinning itself, and it just picks its own speed, and it gives you lift. And so as long as you've got enough forward momentum, you pick its speed and just lift you up. And so it's always an auto rotation. And so if you're up in the sky and you're 500 feet up, you can shut the engine off, which I sometimes do, and you just come down like a feather and just land, because you're always in auto rotation, so you'll never stall. They're stall proof.
The tail section of a gyroplane acts as a horizontal stabilizer, basically keeping the tail down. The rudder is really only needed to keep the aircraft in line during takeoffs and landings. The engine and prop behind the cockpit provide the forward motion. A hydraulic assist gets the rotor started. Forward motion speeds it up to the point where lift is created, and the plane takes off.
You know, you can literally take off without rolling forward at all if you're into a really strong wind. But in general, you probably want a football field or something, 200-300 feet, just to get going, just on a day like today where there's no wind.
People who know aviation know that gyroplanes are nothing new. The autogyro was invented in Spain in 1923 by an engineer named Juan de la Sierva. A forerunner of the helicopter, which came along in 1935, the autogyro was in some ways a solution looking for a problem. It was too slow and couldn't carry enough weight to be of much use in military settings. The big aircraft manufacturers saw no future in it. In 1931, someone had the idea that maybe it could serve as a mail shuttle, demonstrating its capabilities on the White House lawn. Amelia Earhart flew a gyroplane. The concept worked, but never found a use that made it indispensable. The gyroplane never really went away as a hobby aircraft, and a revival of sorts began in the 1980s when a handful of companies began building and selling them. Some flyers build their own. Others build gyroplanes from kits that start at around $15,000. These days, a new full-featured gyroplane with a heated enclosed cockpit can easily cost around $200,000. As is the case with most pursuits of passion, you can start simple, but there's always another level.
I'm hooked. I mean, I just love it. Like, the guys will tell me it's almost annoying how much I'm out here. It's pretty fun. So yeah, I don't regret buying it at all. And like I said, I'm looking at getting another one so I can fly in the cold.